Members, we are going to see how do you handle this proof. It says if x is this, y is this, and z is this, show that the sum of these is equal to that. So the hint we are going to use today is log of p base q equal to r. You get this r power q will be equal to p, like this. When you multiply numbers of the same base, you add the powers, and if this is equal to this, the same base, it means that the powers are equal. So using property 1, it means from here, my a power x is going to be bc. This one is equation 1, comma, b power y equaling to st equation 2, comma, c power z equaling to ab equation 3. Now let's say equation 1 divided by equation 2. I'll be adding now ax equaling to bc over by over sc. Okay, you start by c matrix, then I go small prime. I'll be adding ax times a equaling to by times b. From here, I start, I'm going with this property, I'll add the power, so my ax plus 1 equaling to my by plus 1. Then, from here, and I allow me to make b the subject. I want b here. So I make the subject, I multiply through by this power, so my a becomes x plus 1 over y plus 1 equaling to b. So again here, I'm going to say equation 1 divided by 3. My equation 1 is ax equaling to bc divided by cz divided by ab, which that b answers. I'll be adding ax times a equaling to cz times c. Numbers of the same base when they are multiplying, we add the powers. This is the power and this is the power. So I'll be adding ax plus 1 equaling to cz plus 1. Making c the subject, I multiply by 1 over z plus 1, a times 1 over z plus 1. This will vanish. So I have now my ax plus 1 over z plus 1 equaling to a c. So from there, I see that from equation 1, from 1, you see that my ax is equaling to bc. My ax here will be, from here my b is here, my b is a, x plus 1 over y plus 1, times my c is here, which is a x plus 1 over z plus 1. Still is that I'm having numbers of the same base multiplying. Numbers of the same base, I added the power. So my ax will be, and now I add this and this. I'll be adding x plus 1 over y plus 1. Then plus the power x plus 1 over z plus 1. All these are the powers of that. So still, if this and this are the same base, it means that the powers are equal. So allow me to say from there, x is going to be equal to the power this side, which is x plus 1 over y plus 1, then plus x plus 1 over z plus 1. From here, I'm going to cross multiply up and down. We are adding x equaling to now x plus 1 into z plus 1, then plus x plus 1 into y plus 1, the whole thing over, can it? Y into z plus 1. So now, still I'm going to cross multiply like this. I'll be adding now x into y plus 1, z plus 1, equaling to, now let me expand this, okay, x plus 1 into z plus 1, then plus x plus 1 into y plus 1. Allow me to expand. I'll be adding this as xy plus x. And so, and in bracket, all of this is multiplying z plus 1 equaling 2. Let us expand this one. I'll be adding xz, xz plus x plus z, then plus 1, then plus xy plus x plus y plus 1. Okay, let us expand this and see. This time, this we shall get x, y, z. Then this part, this we have x, y. Then this time, this we have x, z. Then plus this and this we have x. Equaling to x, z plus x plus z plus now this one and this one we get 2. Then plus x, y. Then plus x plus y. Now we do this because space is enough. Now you see that this and this they cancel. What else is cancelling? X, y is also vanishing. So also, what else is vanishing? You see that this x is also vanishing in this. So I have this side x, y, z equaling 2. This side I have x plus y plus z, then plus 2. Taking this side, I have x, y, z, then minus this 2 equaling to x plus y plus z as required. I wish you remember that. Try out more.